Hi, in this video I want to look at the problem of having a upkeep that is larger than your food production, or in general a large upkeep in Guns of Glory. I want to describe how it exactly works and give some tips how to deal with it. To be able to deal with it, it's good to have a good understanding of how it works. So if you look at your estate stats, you will see a total upkeep. I don't have a very large army yet, so my upkeep is still quite okay, but eventually the upkeep will become much and much larger than the production. It already is, but it will become much and much and much larger. So the upkeep means that is that's based on your troops and any upkeep reduction boost you might have active, and that means okay, that is the food your troops would like to eat. If they're unable to eat that food, there is no problem. Your troops won't die if they are not fed. They won't perform any less in combat or gathering. So there is in principle not really an issue. It's just that if you have food available, then it will be eaten by your troops. So what does it mean, food available? That is good to know. So you have a certain storage capacity based on your warehouse. So for example, currently I can hold 550 to K food in my warehouse, which is safe. But any excess food that you have will be eaten by your troops, just as it will be taken by enemies that attack you. Well, that's not a very good comparison, because actually the enemies that attack you also take the food from your farm buildings that is not yet gathered, but your soldiers will not eat that food. So that is something to keep in mind. As long as food is not yet gathered from your farm buildings, it is still safe. So only the food that you have opened up in excess of this storehouse capacity will be eaten by your troops. So keep that in mind. So first, before we go into some tips, I first want to describe how you can increase your food production in various ways, which is going to be important as well. And a lot of these ways also hold for other resources. And having a high production is good, even though gathering goes a lot faster. But having high production is kind of an effortless way to get resources. So that is good to focus on as well. So the first thing is, I always try to maximize the amount of the levels of resource buildings and the amount of resource buildings that I have. Basically fill up all spots. Currently my stronghold or my castle is at level 20, so I also have my most of my resource buildings at level 20. I tend to opt for quite a lot of food buildings, which is maybe at this moment not yet necessary, but later on, when the research projects and the troop training and even the building upgrades require a lot of food, it's good to have a lot of those buildings, even though your upkeep is negative, but more about that later. So those buildings, they give your base food production, and then there are various ways to increase this. One very good way, but unfortunately it costs each time, but it has a huge boost, is using these items, boost items. You get a lot of them for free. You can also buy them in the Alliance shop for not so much credits. So it's definitely, especially if you temporarily want to have a lot, it's very good to have that. And actually having these active also will influence your instant yield talent. So it can really give you quite a lot of extra resources for the 24 hours that it is active. So consider those when you are in a specific need. But in general, you have in your economy research category. Let's have a look at that. There are various food production projects and also for other resources, as I mentioned. But so when you can, try to research those, and you will permanently benefit from those. So that's definitely a good investment. Similarly, if you happen to go for the talent tree, the economy talent tree, you also have food production projects like here, which also give you some extra. I tend to be focused on economy unless I really plan to go for war for a temporary period. I switch to the war tree, but for the rest I focus on economy, because besides this food production projects, it also and other resource production projects also has for gathering, and it has construction research boost, and it has this nice talents like the instant yield and the development talent, which I frequently use. And later on it will also have an instant gather talent, which is even it's also very nice. I wouldn't say even nicer, but it's also very nice. For the rest, there is some equipment, rings and weapons that give food production boost as well. So yeah, consider crafting some of those as well. They can help you with the production as well. And as I said, also that is the same for other resources. Okay, looking at the upkeep, so the amount of troops and the tier of your troops will influence the upkeep that you have, your base upkeep. And I wouldn't worry too much about that. Some players consider dismissing lower level troops when they are, or upgrading troops when they have unlocked higher tier troops. I don't do that, because there is a benefit of having lower tier troops as well. It's just additional troops is good for defense anyway, but it's also that combat against computer opponents like the Red Guard raids and the Red Guard rallies and other computer opponents, sometimes in special events or even the even beast. It helps of having a mix of tiers, actually a mix of troops and a mix of tiers to do the most damage. So for that purpose, if somebody has tier 9 troops alone or tier 8 troops alone, and I have lower tier troops but I have a mix, I can outperform them because I have this this mix of tiers and troops. So consider that, and instead of dismissing those troops or upgrading those troops, just train new troops of higher gear, and don't worry too much about the upkeep. The upkeep is just something you need to deal with. So besides that base upkeep, there are also some ways to reduce it. That's still useful. It's not very necessary, but it's still useful. So in the development research category, there are some upkeep reduction projects. Let's have a look at those as well. Development, and here we have one of the upkeep reduction programs. I haven't researched both of them yet. Currently researching a very important other project, which is March slots 3, unlocking my fifth March slot. So that's a way to get a little bit of extra upkeep. There are two equipments, the merchant shoes and the aristocrat boots, that provide some upkeep reduction at a higher level. And in the alliance research trees, there's a level 4, 6, and 8 an efficiency project that gives some upkeep reduction boost. And what's quite important is that there are two items that you can buy for gold, but they give it for 24 hours 25% or 50% upkeep reduction boost that you can buy for 500 or 900 gold. Actually, the 50% the 25% one you also get quite often as a reward. Not really know where I get them from, but I have I have some of them. And those are useful when you start collecting food, or you start opening up your resources to do a really large castle upgrade, for example. Then it can be useful to put this upkeep reducer on, so to you minimize the losses of your food. Okay, so now I want to share some tips. So one of them is relating to your farm resource buildings. So basically, they can go on producing for 10 hours if you don't have any boosts. And I think with boost, most of the time, the boost might also increase the storage capacity. But yeah, so you can, the idea is you can go on for quite some time. And once you have, once your storage is actually at max capacity and you're not going to use your food, it's not really useful to add to gather, to harvest your farm buildings, because the food that you farm will just be eaten by your troops. So it is actually better to keep them at max capacity, those farms, and wait with harvesting them until you're really going to need them, or when you're going to do your troop training, or when you're going to do some research project that requires food. So that's going to be useful, and just harvesting them all the time, which might be in your nature, it's not really the best way to do things. So what you should also do is focus on saving up food in safe ways. That can be, for example, your food items that you get. Collect those. Don't use them right away. In the Alliance warehouse, store some food. I tend to store food there. Because it will just be eaten up if you use keep it in your own account. There are also things like donation rewards. You can actually collect these as long as you want, your Alliance knowledge rewards, and you can still use these when you need it. They also contain some nice amount of food, so when you need it, just open them up. Can keep them for weeks to go. Also your quests, maybe you can consider not using up your quests, not claiming all your quests. Quite some of them contain food as well. So only do that once you are working towards like a next castle upgrade, and then start opening up a bunch of quests before using up your food items. Also the used arms items, that you can use. You can also collect these and wait with using them, and you can change them into food at the munition exchange, and only do that once you need it. Okay, those are some tips on that, on safe ways to collect food. So once you need a relatively small amount of food for your troop training or a building upgrade or a research project, do not right away use up your safe food, like your items, but first consider the following. So you can, for example, time ahead and send out all your marches to collect food, to gather food on farm tiles. This gives you quite a significant amount of food at the same time. You can decide to harvest all your fully loaded farms, like what we described before. You can use an instant yield talent, and later on you can also use an instant gather talent if you have unlocked that. And this way you can already accumulate quite some food that should be sufficient for most of your smaller requirements, so that you can keep your safe food until you are going for a larger castle upgrade. What's also good to consider is the guards. So if you have John Felton, that's definitely a good one to have. Also to keep focusing on, because it's it can give a construction food requirement as well once you have increased it to 3 stars. But the research food requirement is already quite nice and will be sufficient for a lot of the small research projects in the beginning. And still, I now have 820. Maybe I'm going to upgrade it a bit more. Having like 1 million of food deduced from your research requirements is quite helpful. Yeah, you can consider, I've already used up quite some points for Planchet. Maybe you should consider, you could reconsider whether you really want to do this. It's quite expensive, these pink ones, and you can also wait out until you say, yeah, at a later stage, I might have my John Felton upgraded to 3 stars, and then you actually get a 1.6 million construction food requirement, and it will be, yeah, at that stage, the planchet one will be useless unless you decide to upgrade that to various stars as well. But actually, without spending significant amount of money, upgrading the purple or pink guards is going to be very, very hard to do. So keep that in mind as well. But actually, so that John Felton is very useful for your, for all those small research projects. To not use food at all, or to at least deduce the amount of food you need significantly. So at the later stage of the game, it will, when you go to your, maybe starting from castle 24, 23, 25, around that level, it becomes very hard to collect the amount of food you need from your in a safe way completely, or it just becomes very useful if you can store food in a safe way, and for that a farm account, a zero upkeep farm account, is going to be very useful. Building up farm accounts can take quite a long time. I have four farm accounts in Guns of Glory. Actually, I don't have a zero upkeep farm account yet. That becomes very useful at a later stage. Do build these farm accounts. Start with that early on if you plan to play this game for a very long time. They will be very useful, more or less a requirement at a later stage, unless you spend large amounts of money. So do consider that to start early with building some farm accounts. Earlier on, what you might also do is have a kind of a shared farm account, or maybe a shared zero upkeep account. Zero upkeep, when I refer to that, is just an account without troops. So that everyone in the alliance can send their excess food to this zero upkeep account and retrieve it by attacking it when it is required. So that's a good way to keep some, to not waste your food as well. So I hope this, this has taken away some concern that, having a large upkeep is not really that much of an issue. Actually, you can easily work around it if you understand how it works and use the tips. Maybe you have some other tips that you want to share. That's always welcome. Please feel free to share that in the comment section. I hope you like this guide. Thanks for thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, please consider doing so. That will really be helpful for me. Hey, thanks again.